high-end racing games such as Forza Motorsports requires an insane level of details for the cars. So, the actual racing car is scanned carefully by tons of modern equipment to create a super detailed model with the accuracy at millimeter level. It's very impressive. But who does it better? A professional team with laser and cameras, or a group of students with yardsticks? It's true. The very first object was scanned in history in Unso car, a Volkswagen Beetle. The scan work was done manually with yardsticks by the student from University of Utah in 1970s. One of them even invented the blinn-phong shading method to render this VW bug correctly. Who is he? Back to the USA, 1968. Ivan Sutherland had just created the first virtual reality system in the world called the Sword of Damocles while being an associate professor at Harvard University. These optical see-through head-mounted display using Sutherland's VR system were a stock item used by US military helicopter pilots to view the cameras mounted on the helicopter's belly. Realize the potential of CGI, Department of Defense funded $5 million to the three-year-old computer science department of the University of Utah led by David Evans. David talked to Ivan about the challenges and Ivan joined him in teaching computer graphics in UFU. The powerful resources at Utah were instrumental in attracting the very best faculty, students and collaborators to work with David Evans and Ivan Sutherland. They scour the research community to attract the best talent among the skill set required. From MIT, they recruited engineering and signal processing talent. From Ecole Polytechnique and other universities in France, they attracted the mathematical talent of students, and one of them is Bui Tuong Phong. Before Phong, Henri Gouraud went to the University of Utah and has just achieved a big step in rendering the curved surface. His method is well known with the name of gouraud shading. This method produced much more realistic image than any other methods existed at that time. But very soon, Phong would surprise us. In 1972, Sutherland challenged a group of his students to choose something iconic to realistically render, and they selected the Volkswagen Beetle as a symbol of global culture because it was large enough to measure as a group and because Ivan's wife, Masha, owned one. The rendering method was a points and polygon description. Each auto part shared a set of points and lines that was painted on the surface of the Beetle to describe a set of mostly flat polygons. The Beetle was assumed to have left-to-right symmetry, so they measured only half of the car. A volleyball stanchion and joints in the pavement formed a three-dimensional reference system. They used yardsticks to measure the x, y, and z coordinates of the painted points on the car surface. Jim Clark and Robert McDermott were taller, so they arranged to have the higher points of the car. Bui Tuong Phong and Raphael Rom were shorter, so they measured the lower sections. The process was slow and tedious, taking many class sessions to complete. Masha was a wonderful sport as he drove the car around the town, festooned with their markings. After each measurement session, they entered by hand list of point coordinates into a text data file. The list of polygons was also entered as a list of integer indices, referencing the set of points. Since a vertex could be shared across the nearby polygons, this smart way of describing model is still used nowadays in the most high-end systems. The model of the VW bug was ready. The next step is rendering. A 3D model needs a shading method to calculate the color for each pixel on its surface to express the depth and space. At that time, there are only two reasonable choices, which are the flat shading method and the gouraud shading method. In the flat shading method, each polygon has a normal vector, and the normal vector is used to calculate the diffuse color for every pixel in that polygon. Then, the transition from polygon to polygon is discrete and easy to be spotted by naked eyes. As suggested by its name, this method is not ideal for rendering curved surface like the VW bug. In the gouraud shading method, each vertex has a separated normal vector, so it could store the calculated vertex color. The color for each pixel in the polygon is just the result of a quick linear interpolation between vertex colors. This method produces much more realistic image, since the transition between polygons is smoother thanks to the interpolation. However, it's not perfect. Bui Tuong Phong found out that the speckle highlights are often inappropriately shaped, since they depend upon the deep precision and shape of the polygons. Moreover, the shading of a surface in motion has annoying discontinuity due to the changing orientation of the polygons. Then, he decided to create his own shading method to eliminate those excesses. Firstly, he invented the technique of Phong interpolation, allowing approximation of normal vector for every position on the surface. He did that by interpolating the normal vectors of the vertices forming the polygon. Secondly, he created a lighting model to simulate the interaction of the light with the surface. This is later called Phong reflection model, and I am trying to explain this math model in a simple way. Consider a light ray hitting the surface at a point. We will look at the angle between the light direction and the normal vector at that position. Smaller angle means the normal vector direction is close to the light direction, so the contact part of the surface receives a lot of light, and it should be bright. On the other hand, bigger angle means darker diffuse color. Don't stop at that. When the light ray bounces off the surface, the reflection angle is equal to the incident angle. If the reflected light ray hits the viewer's eye or the camera, the contact point should have a very bright speckle highlight. That's why we should consider the angle between the reflecting direction and the view direction. Similar to the diffuse color, smaller angle means brighter specular color, and Phong reflection model is the first one in the world describing the specular phenomenon. Finally, he combined Phong interpolation with his own reflection model to create a brand new shading method which produces much more realistic image than gouraud shading. His PhD dissertation about this method was published in 1973. His shading method was named after him, Phong shading. It quickly became the new de facto baseline for rendering 3D models. Phong shading is widely used until today along with its variants. Next time seeing Phong something in the 3D software, your heart knows that is the result of this masterpiece from Bui Tuong Phong 50 years ago. Do you notice that I use the term shading method instead of shader? It is because the term shader would not be available in the next 15 years after the event. Phong shading is much better than gouraud shading in describing the curved surface, especially the stable specular highlight. But it also requires more computational work since you need to apply the reflection model for each pixel. You have to make a trade-off between realistic rendering and the performance. Phong interpolation suggested that each pixel could have its own normal vector somehow. This concept might be the inspiration for some advanced techniques like bump mapping and normal mapping. Jim Blinn, the creator of these techniques, is also the one improved Phong shading to reduce the computational works. The new and improved method is named after both of them, which is blinn-phong. This used to be the default lighting model for many modern 3D softwares like 3ds Max, Maya, Blender, or Unity. If you know what Jim Blinn did to improve Phong shading, or you have the same question, leave a comment below. After receiving his PhD, Bui Tuong Phong was asked to be a tenure at the University of Utah. 2 years later, Stanford University invited him to be a professor there. At his peak, he died in 1975 when he was just 33 years old. Bui Tuong Phong took only 1 year to finish his PhD dissertation, much faster than other students, because he knew he got leukemia and didn't have much time left. His death is a big loss. According to Professor Ivan Sutherland and Phong's friend, Phong was intelligent, affable, and modest. Phong shading is honored in the history page of the University of Utah. He even appears in the list of 25 most influential persons from the beginning of the department until now, though he worked there for only 3 years. Many said that without Phong shading, computer graphics would be very different. Some important softwares might not even exist. This might be true, since he influenced many students in the University of Utah while he was there, more or less. Jim Clark, the tall guy measuring the VW bug roof, is the founder of Silicon Graphics. OpenGL is developed by this great company. John Warnock, the creator of flash trading, is the founder of Adobe, which develops famous software like Photoshop, Illustrator, and After Effects. Ed Catmull, the president of both Disney and Pixar Animation Studio. He influenced and inspired many computer graphics researchers to contribute to the world we know today, but his information was very limited. Most of his works were only recorded when he went to the US. This is what we know about him. Phong was born in 1942 in Hanoi. After attending the Lai Chi Arabesa role there, he moved with his family to Saigon in 1954, where he attended the Lai Chi Jean Jacques Rousseau. He went to France in 1964 and was admitted to the Grenoble Institute of Technology, which is an elite education institute with high admission requirements. He received his Bachelor of Science from Grenoble in 1966. He continued to study about engineering at ANSET, a top-ranking French Republic engineering school with insane competitiveness located in Toulouse. He received his Master of Engineer here in 1968. After that, he joined the area as a researcher in computer science, working in the development of operating systems for digital computers, while most of the humans on the Earth have no clue what a computer or software is. In 1971, he heard about Ivan Sklar of computer graphics from the other side of the Atlantic Ocean. He was attracted to this new area and went to the University of Utah. The rest is history.